Welcome to the channel. Today we'll determine whether methane is a greenhouse gas or not, right? Okay, can you tell me what is greenhouse gas? Okay, let me tell you what is greenhouse gas, right? Okay, so here is the definition of greenhouse gas. A greenhouse gas is a gas that absorbs and emits radiant energy within the thermal infrared range. That is, a greenhouse gas can absorb IR radiation and emit IR radiation, right? Okay. So what is the to be greenhouse gas? Either the molecule must possess a dipole moment or some of its vibrational motions must generate a temporary dipole moment, right? If you don't know what is dipole moment, then let me show you the definition of dipole moment, right? Okay, here is the definition of dipole moment. You can easily remember. The dipole moment of a molecule is the product of the charge and the distance between charges, right? That is, if the distance means bond length changes due to vibration, then dipole moment will be changed, right? If dipole moment change, then the molecule will be IR active, right? Okay, so look at the vibration of methane, right? Here is the vibration of methane, right? This bond is also tracing. This bond is compressing, but this bond is tracing. This bond is compressing. So since bond length is changing, so dipole moment will be changed. As a result, methane is a IR active molecule, right? Methane is a IR active molecule. That is, IR active means methane is a greenhouse gas, right? Okay, let me show the mechanism how methane absorb the temperature, right? Okay, methane will absorb the IR radiation and it will come from lower vibrational level to higher vibrational level, right? And you know that in higher vibrational level, methane molecule is unstable, so it will try to come back to its lower vibrational level by releasing energy, and the released energy is responsible for global warming or greenhouse effect, right? However, look at these things. These energetically excited molecules soon lose their excess energy either by collision with other molecules or by spontaneous emission of radiation. Part of this radiation is emitted to outer face and part returns to the Earth's surface. I will have a blog post. You can read that blog post. So thank you for viewing this video. Be well.